Next up, we'll be hiding the list of categories that we came up with. So let's flip back over to our app, and over here we can see the quote-unquote ideal view that we came up with that we want our model to look like when we first pop open our app. So this is not going to happen right now. If I refresh this, so you'll notice that we have our full view of the house. So I captured the names of the categories that we need to hide to get to our ideal view state. And in order to make this happen programmatically, where we turn off the categories, let's head on over to VS Code. So over here, I have the app.tsx file open, and we went over this briefly in the last chapter. The thing I want us to focus on is this viewer component, which actually renders our iTwin viewer. Now, the most common question we get is, where is the entry point for your own code? When do you know that the iTwin viewer has successfully loaded? So there is a pop for that, a callback called on iModel connected. And this is called right after the iTwin viewer gets initialized and we have an open iModel connection that we can start talking to. So let's go ahead and add a method for that. We'll call it on iModel connected. And it's going to return an iModel connection handle. So let's define that here. iModel connection. Now let's declare this and pass it into our prop. Perfect. So this right here will give us our iModel connection, and that gives us an ability to start querying data within our iModel. We'll use this here in a sec. For now, let's just do a basic hello world here so that we know that we are in the context of the app. So let's just do hello world, save that, and open up our app, reloads, and console hello world. So you can see that we have found the entry point into our app. Now let's start modifying our view. Now when it comes to modifying the view, we need to capture yet another event, which is called the onViewOpen, which is called every time our view is open, because that's when we can start actually changing stuff that's happening in the viewport. And how do we capture that event? There is this class called the iModelApp. This is a global singleton that connects us to a bunch of iModel.js services. It's got a bunch of static methods that give us access to Helper API that we'll be using. And the one that we want to use here is called the View Manager, which is responsible for managing the different views that our app is using and also capturing events. So the event we're looking for is onViewOpen. And we're going to add a listener to this. We only need to add it once because we just want to capture the event the first time it opens. And this is going to return our handle to our screen viewport. Now, just like the iModel connection that we saw, the screen viewport is another very important class. It gives us the ability to interact with our viewport. And anytime you want to add stuff to the viewport, such as decorators or markers, or if you want to modify things with the view state, then we will be using this class. So keep that in mind. And don't worry too much about memorizing all these API, the iModel connection, the screen viewport, the iModel app. They're going to keep coming up, so you'll have plenty of time to get familiar with them. Okay, so let's go ahead and declare an empty function here. And now we're in a place where we can start turning off some categories. The method for that is change category display. And what it allows you to do is enable or disable display of elements belonging to a set of categories specified by ID. So this is exactly the method we need to disable our categories. The only thing though, we need to pass the category IDs, and all we have with us are the category names. So we need a way to find the IDs of categories with this name. And the way we can do that is you have to head on over to the iModel console app and write a query that's going to give us the list of IDs from our category names. So let's do that next.